करुणा कर दिनहि न जाने मौसम पतित प्रभु नाहि त्रिभुवने
गौरंग करुणा करो दिनहि न जाने
मौसम
पतित प्रभु नाहि त्रिभुवने
गौरंग करुणा कर दिनहि न जाने मौसम पतित प्रभु नाहि त्रिभुवने
गौरंग करुणा करो दिनहि न जाने मौसम पतित प्रभु नाहि त्रिभुवने
दन्ते तृणाधरि गौर डाकिहे तोमार कृपा करि ऐसयामार हृदय मन्दिरे
दन्ते तृणाधरि
डाकी है
तुम्हारे
हमार दया मंदिरे यदि दया ना करिबे पतित देखिया पतित पावन राम किशर लागि नाना कोरि रे पतित देखिया पतित पावन राम किशर पड़े चि भवतु फाने नाहि कानिस्तार श्रीचरण तरणी दाने दासे करो पार
भवतु पाने नाहि निस्तार श्रीचरण तारणी दाने दासे करो पार
श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु दासे रनुरास प्रार्थना करये सदा नरतम दास
श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु दासे रनुदास प्रार्थना कर नरोत्तम दास
गौरंग करुणा कर दिनहि न जाने मौसम पतित प्रभु नाहि त्रिभुवने
गौरंग करुणा करो
सीता गदाधर श्रीवासादी गौरा भक्त वृंद
श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादी गौरा भक्त वृंद
कृष्ण हरे 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 रामा हरे रामा 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे
पावन हरिनाम संकीर्तन की
जय
अनंत कोटि वै वैष्णव वृंद की
जय।
श्रील प्रभुपाद की
जय।
चैतन्य चरतामृत की
जय।
श्री श्री गौर निताय की
जय।
हरे कृष्ण। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमावों विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादि पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण। वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द चैतन्य चरितामृत 10th चैप्टर द मध्य लीला। वी आर प्रोसीडिंग फर्दर। Yesterday we began one topic which we haven't discussed on that, which is Kala Krishna Das. Mahaprabhu called for him. Let us see what happened after that. What is the verse number? What was it? 66. Yes. So, Chaitanya Charitamrita. Madhyalila 10.66. Yes, this is the verse. Etashuni Krishna Dasa Kandite Lagila.
Etashuni Krishna Dasa Kandite Lagila.
Madhyanha Karite Mahaprabhu Chaligela. Yeah, actually, Yatashini means hearing what Krishna Das cried. Here, he heard what was spoken in the previous verse. See what Mahaprabhu said in these two verses, again we will repeat, very important. Huh? Mahaprabhu is saying here, just consider the character of this man who went with me to South India. You are showing this? Yeah. He left my company to associate with Bhattacharyas. But I rescued him from their company and brought him here. Now that I have brought him here, I am asking him to leave. Now he can go wherever he likes, for I am no longer responsible for him. So here is a very important purport Prabhupada says here, which we read yesterday. One lesson we learnt from this episode of Kala Krishna Das being attracted by the gypsies and the Bhattatari people. That happened because, Prabhupada says in this purport here, even if one is in the company of the Supreme Lord Krishna or Lord Chaitanya, one can get carried away in this material world due to getting diverted by Maya. Actually, Maya is always 24/7 available for everybody in this world. If somebody shows interest in her, then one will get misled. We have seen even students with very good character in their school days, in their college days, they got spoiled because of bad company, making friendship with bad people. So there is always choice at every moment in our lives. So even associates like Dvivida Gorilla, Narakasya Sakha Kashchit, Dvivido Nama Vanaraha, there is a verse in the Bhagavatam. He made friendship with Naraka Asura. Who is Naraka Asura? Bhaumasura. So if Duvida is making friendship with Bhaumasura, Bhaumasura is making friendship with Banasura, and they are all like the birds of the same feather. They actually pollute each other more and more by becoming blasphemers against the Lord. In this way, Duvida is supposed to be almost like associate like Hanuman. Hanuman became a immortal character in this world. The people always remember Hanuman very joyfully. So Hanuman used to be always at the feet of Sitaram. But Vivida Gorilla used to stand on one side. He was also associate of Lord Rama. He became envious of Lakshman. Later on fell prey to bad association with Bhaumasura, Narakasura. Narakasya Sakha Kaschid, Duvido Nama Vanaraha. That Vanara became degraded. He had to be later on killed by Balaram. Duvida Gorilla. He became very extremely mischievous and naughty. So you will find like this, somebody associate of the Lord can become so degraded. So we should not get frightened by hearing this. Oh, if this can happen to Lord's associate, what to speak of us? We are tiny souls. So therefore the Shastras give us warning that big demigods like Indra or Brahma can be subjected to illusion if they are not careful. Indra became proud and Brahma became speculative. And in this way, we find learn from them how not to be speculative or how not to be proud. From devatas we learn. They are all very great souls. Sometimes the Lord teaches the living entities through great devotees. Can learn in our lives not to imitate that erratic behavior. Similarly here, Kala Krishna Das became attracted by Maya. So he even left the company of Lord Chaitanya to go to Bhattatari's camp. But Mahaprabhu fortunately caught hold of Ishika. And then he dragged him back, saved him. So in this way, when Mahaprabhu came back, this is what he said, that now let him go wherever he wants. You know, he can leave my company, like that Mahaprabhu said. Therefore he started crying, Krishnadas. Because Krishnadas was simple and innocent and naive, and he became fooled by the Bhattataris, who showed him allurements of beautiful bungalows, beautiful women, and nice comforts and luxuries for him to live. And their plan was to take him into their camp and use him to produce more children and vamshavriti in their own society. And they were nomads. Nomads means they move from place to place, that kind of people, gypsies. So, and Kala Krishnadas became fooled by them. Now he realized very soon when Mahaprabhu saved him. You will find that a falling down person, you know, sometimes he knows what is right, but is unable to stick to the right because of weakness of heart. The weakness of heart makes a fool out of him. So that means the spiritual strength is weak. So one has to actually become more stronger. Now why he was not strong even in the company of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you may have a question. Even Arjuna in the beginning of the battle of Kurukshetra, you find he is standing just 2 feet ahead of Krishna, but he is weeping. You know, can anybody enlighten Arjuna more than Krishna? Now Krishna is so, supremely knowledgeable. But Arjuna was cut off from Krishna in the beginning. Cut off in the sense he was independent. He was thinking, I know everything. He was not taking advantage of Krishna's association. So therefore, being with Krishna was not very advantageous for Arjuna in the beginning. But very quickly he realized his mistake. And he not only cried, he fell at the feet of Krishna and said, you are my guru now. Shishyaste aham shadi mam tvam prapanna. And then Krishna, when he instructed Arjuna, then he became enlightened. So we may be right next to a very great spiritual master, or we may be very close to Krishna himself or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. But if we are cut off from them by becoming independent, then we are taking an about turn. We are showing our back to them, and we are taking advantage of, you know, Maya's gifts in this world, and then we may get carried away like that. So therefore Arjuna, you will find at the end of Gita, he says, Karishye Vachanam Tava, he says. Then he aligned with Krishna. Then no more unhappiness. He became happy after that. And he became duty bound, he became responsible, he became joyful, he became victorious. Everything good happened. So now, when Mahaprabhu silently brought him, Mahaprabhu didn't chastise him in South India. If he did, probably Krishnadas would have run away or something. or Krishnadas would have gone into more deeper maya. So for admonishment or chastisement, that is the right time. Everything has the right time. You know, just like in a kitchen when you are cooking dal or sabji or whatever, you have to put chowk. That should be put at the right time. So in the chowk, you all know, we have the mustard seed, isn't it? The mustard seed, sometimes people heat a little bit and immediately put the chowk, but the mustard seed is not exploded. Then that mustard seed, when it comes in the mouth, it will be very bad. It will be like oily. It will be very bad. Sometimes you keep, you know, making the chowk in the fire, but then some phone call comes. Then what happens? Tap, 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 all of them are bursting. And many of the mustard seeds become very burnt, roasted. And that also will not give good taste. It will spoil the whole dal. In the same manner, if your chastisement is more than what a person deserves, or what a person can take, then that person will become like a burnt cookie. And in case you don't give him, you know, some punishment, he may take the matter very cheaply. Especially Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in two instances you find, he acted very strongly. One is Krishnadas, we read here. Another instance is Chota Haridas. In these two instances, you know, connection with opposite sex was involved. Attraction to the opposite sex. So Mahaprabhu was very heavy. He wanted to leave behind these two examples for all time to come. That if somebody becomes hypocritical in dealing with the opposite sex, then Mahaprabhu will deal with them very strongly, up to the point of banishing them from association. So Chota Haridas was banished from association of Vaishnavas. And Mahaprabhu couldn't be pacified at all, even by Paramananda Puri and even by the other fellow Vaishnavas. Here in this case, Krishnadas was a servant of Nityananda. So therefore Mahaprabhu thought, no, I want to reject him, but it is up to Nityananda what he wants to do with him. So he brought him back to Puri. And as soon as he brought him back, he handed him over to the Vaishnavas and said, now I don't want to see him anymore. Let him leave my company and do whatever he wants. Wherever he wishes to go, he may go. Which actually means you sprinkle water on the head and say, get lost now. Do whatever you want. See, this is more painful than punishment also. Because if somebody punishes us, you know, it may pain for a while and then they didn't, you know, remove you from their association. Correct, no? Here in this case, you are not going to be entertained anymore. Go wherever you want, do whatever you wish. If one says like that means you are independent-minded. Now you are no more connected to me, do whatever you want. So therefore he cried, Krishnadas. Eta shuni Krishnadasa kandite lagila. मध्यान करिते महाप्रभु चले गेला. Yeah. So, see, when hearing that Lord has rejected him, which causes the greatest pain to the devotee, Kalakrishnadas began to cry. But what did Mahaprabhu, did his heart melt because of that? No, he not caring for him, immediately left to take his noon lunch. Actually, Lord wanted to teach Krishnadas a solid lesson that, you know, this kind of independent mentality will destroy your spiritual life. So he didn't even look at him, he just turned away and went for his lunch. Nityananda Jagadananda Mukunda Damodara Chari Jane Yukti Tabe Karila Antara. These four people, Nityananda, Jagadananda, Mukunda and Damodar, they all came together and made a plan by which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has rejected him, Kalakrishnadas, but he cannot at the same time be protected and given assurance by some method so that he will not have to give up Krishna consciousness and go away. Very important purport. Please read it.
Even though a person is rejected by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the devotees of the Lord do not reject him. Therefore, the Lord's devotees are more merciful than the Lord Himself. Shri Narottamdas Thakur has thus sung, Chadiya Vaishnava Seva Nistara Paiche Keba. One cannot be relieved from the material clutches without engaging in the service of pure devotees. The Lord Himself may sometimes be very hard, but the devotees are always kind. Thus, Kali Krishnadas received the mercy of the four devotees mentioned above.
Mm-hmm. See, Lord told him, go wherever he likes, let him go wherever he likes, and I am no more responsible for him. Like that Lord Chaitanya said. But devotees thought, if he is not under anyone's responsibility, his life will be ruined. Huh? In Bhagavad Gita, Prabhupada says in one of the verses, Krishna Minna Vichalayet, in that purport he says, I'll just check it if I can locate it. You can see what Prabhupada says there. Yeah, I can read this, huh?
Men who are ignorant cannot appreciate activities in Krishna consciousness, and therefore Lord Krishna advises us not to disturb them and simply waste valuable time.
Yeah, this is 3.29 Bhagavad Gita. Here Prabhupada is writing a purport. There Krishna says, these ignorant fools, don't chase after them, leave them. Let them get some kicks from Maya, and after some lifetimes they will come back. Slowly, huh? They'll get to purify first. And if you try to preach to them, they will not listen to you. They're very adamant for sense gratification. But then, what purpose is it further?
But the devotees of the Lord are more kind than the Lord because they understand the purpose of the Lord.
This is the most important. Please repeat this. Devotees of the Lord.
Devotees of the Lord.
Are more kind than the Lord.
More kind than the Lord.
Because they understand the purpose of the Lord.
They understand the purpose of the Lord.
What is the purpose of the Lord? Lord wants to see ultimately everybody go back to Godhead. But if somebody is not listening, the devotees are still ready to be merciful. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu didn't even consider Jagaya Madai, but Nityananda Prabhu considered delivering them. Nobody in this world would have considered hippies, but Prabhupada considered them. And nobody would even look at a prostitute, especially those who are religious. Truly religious and truly saintly, why would ever they look at even a prostitute? But when a prostitute came on the order of, Ramchandra Khan had sent her to assassinate the character of Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur took pity on her and made her into a devotee in 3 days. So you will find this, great souls, this is one of their custodial qualities adored by even the Supreme Lord, which is they are more merciful than the Lord. Prabhupada says the devotees of the Lord are more kind, are more merciful than the Lord. And then consequently, what do they do?
Consequently, they undertake all kinds of risk, even to the point of approaching ignorant men to try to engage them in the acts of Krishna consciousness, which are absolutely necessary for the human being.
Sometimes there may be risk involved. Sometimes devotees are beaten up in some places for distributing books. In some places, sometimes they are put in the jail. Sometimes some of the apostles of Jesus were, thrown to the hungry lions. And some of them were put in a hot oil pan and they were fried like puris. There was one apostle of Jesus, he was put in an oil pan and then his body bulged like a puri. Still he didn't die. He was remembering the Lord. So when he came out, he was allowed to walk away after that. So you find any preacher in any part of the world who is trying to love God and propagate Lord's glories, they may be taken to task. Like you find Prahlad was taken to great task, troubled by his own father, Hiranyakashipu. You find Ambarish Maharaj. Simply because you want to be a devotee, the Pandavas, how much they were tortured, you can see that. So, but the beauty of these great souls is, despite all suffering, they will still wonder how I can save this suffering souls. Like Prahlad prayed for the deliverance of his father. So, therefore, the devotees have a very, very kind heart. They think about how to save this person, poor fellow. Like that they were thinking. Therefore, these four people came together and made a plan. What was that? Gauda deshe pathayite chahe yeka jana. Aike kahi beyai. Prabhura agamana. आई के मीन सची माता, आई के कहिबे आई, सो गो एंड टेल मदर सची दैट प्रभुर आगमन, दैट चैतन्य महाप्रभु हैज कम बैक फ्रॉम हिज प्रीचिंग टूर, लेट हिम गो एंड टेल सची माता, बिकॉज वेन शी हियर्स दिस हर हार्ट विल ब्लॉसम विथ ग्रेट जॉय, ओ माई सन इज बैक नाउ, एंड विथ हार्ट फुल ऑफ gratitude she will appreciate and bless this fellow who Kalakrishna Das. Yeah, advaita shri vasadi yata bhakta gana sabe asibe shuni prabhur agamana. Yeah,
after hearing news of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's arrival, devotees like Advaita and Srivas will certainly come to see him.
Hey Krishna Dase Diba Gaude Pathaya. Yeta Kahitare Rakhi Lena Ashvasya. Yeah, really?
Let us therefore send Krishna Das to Bengal. See, saying this, they kept Krishna Das engaged in the service of the Lord and gave him assurance.
So two things they did. One is they gave him a service which will attract blessings. That's the first thing they did. Second thing they did, they gave him assurance that don't think you are rejected by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Don't think you are gone. Don't think you are doomed. Don't become hopeless. You know, mercy of the Lord is always there. It will come back to you. Eventually, when you please the Lord, He will be again pleased with you. So they gave him like kind of assurance they gave him. So the assurance would have pacified him and service would have blessed him. Correct, no? So in this way, the Vaishnavas are very intelligent on how to save a soul who is gliding down in a downward spiral, you know, to Patala. How to, you know, go and lift up such a soul. Yeah.
आरदेने प्रभु स्थाने कैल निवेदन आज्ञा देह गौड़ देशे पठाई एक जन.
सो नेक्स्ट डे दे वेंट टू चैतन्य महाप्रभु एंड सेड, माय डियर लॉर्ड, वी वांट योर परमिशन टू सेंड वन पर्सन टू गौड़ देश. सो व्हाट इज द इंटेलिजेंस ऑफ द वैष्णवास? हु इज दैट वन पर्सन दैट दे डिडंट से? Do you think Mahaprabhu is not aware of it? Mahaprabhu is aware. See what Mahaprabhu will say here. Now.
Tumara dakshina gamana shuni sachi aayi.
Advaita adi bhakta sabha ache dukha paayi. So Mother Sachi, Advaita Acharya Prabhu, they all are very much unhappy due to your, you know, they are all very unhappy due to not receiving any news. You went to south and where you preach and what happened, when are you coming back? There was no time limit set. They are all very worried.
Eka jana yai kaho shubha samachara. Prabhu kahe sehi kara ye icha tomara.
Very beautiful verse it is. He is saying, Eka jana yai. He is saying, we are planning to send one person, Kahukshubha Samachar, to give good news to all the Vaishnavas in Bengal. At that time, Mahaprabhu said, Sai Kara. He said, okay, do that. Ye Icha Tomara. If that is your desire. Like that, Mahaprabhu says. Do whatever you decide. Like that, Mahaprabhu said. Mahaprabhu understood whom they will send. They are very intelligent to give service. See, they are intelligent, Mahaprabhu super intelligent, because he is Krishna and devotee simultaneously, you know, isn't it? So you do think Mahaprabhu is not aware that they are showing some compassion upon? Yeah. Something similar happened with Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur's one disciple. Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur was very upset with one of the disciples for some mistake and he rejected him. Then later on he told the devotees, I have rejected him, but you can show him mercy. Because if I also reject, you also reject, he'll be gone. Like that he said. But he doesn't deserve to come in my presence. He doesn't deserve to connect with me. And I don't want to see his face. But I don't want to see him get destroyed either. I want to see him survive, but he is not qualified to work with me, or because he has committed some big mistake or whatever. So here one very important lesson we should learn, that just because, despite the Lord's rejecting, devotee saved him, it doesn't mean you can do anything and everything. And every time you do a big blunder and go to devotee and say, my dear devotees, you are all merciful, any nasty blunder I break the four regulative principles, and I just keep thinking, I just come and be with devotees, chant and dance with devotees, and they will take care of me. That is coming under which offense? Seventh offense. Namno baladyasihi papa buddhi. In fact, that offense is so strong that one will not be able to chant the holy name at all. One will completely lose the taste for the holy name because of such an offensive and duplicitous and cunning mentality. And that was not the case with Kalakrishnadas. Kalakrishnadas actually fell away. In one or two purports you will find he was simple, he was innocent, he was carried away momentarily. And therefore, he will not do anything duplicitous subsequently. He has come back. Company, yeah. In the same manner, amongst the Prabhupada disciples, in the early days, many of them were coming from a hippie background and everything. And Prabhupada saw that in case anybody is trying to mix with some members of the opposite sex, Prabhupada immediately tell the temple president that you should get him married. This is not for, those who are in the saintly order. If somebody is becoming loose with respect to opposite sex, basically, he is weak-hearted. I mean, he has some shortcomings, weaknesses in dealing with a particular woman. Then you get married immediately. And let them be situated as a proper grihastha. That's ideal. And otherwise, wearing the robes of a sannyasi or a brahmachari, one thinks, I earn a lot of respect. At the same time, I can also enjoy sense gratification. Then one is called as a monkey. He is not a monk, he is a monkey. Why? The monk becomes monkey when he becomes godas, when he becomes a slave of his senses, and then he becomes degraded. And that is what Mahaprabhu condemns very strongly. If one is in the renounced order, then one has to stick to that order. One cannot follow that order. Then you get married, there are so many grihasthas who are faithfully, honestly practicing their grihastha life as a devotee. Then one should follow in their footsteps. But there are certain cases where a monk doesn't fall away completely, nor does he need to go for married life. There are some borderline cases like that. Like somebody showed some interest in somebody and then quickly realized, this is not meant for me. Just like that monkey who sat on the back of a crocodile and went to, later on he realized the water is not my place. Similarly, there are boys who have gone with their friends to, just out of friendship, but then the friends gave them a cigarette and they came running back. They would never touch a cigarette in their life. Gandhi says, in his fifth standard, somebody gave him a piece of meat. He wouldn't eat at all. He was a vegetarian and everything, but his friends insisted a lot. So one piece he put in the mouth. Immediately vomited it. In the night, when he was sleeping, a dream came and the goat came. Meh, he was saying, why are you trying to eating me? Why did you try to eat me? Gandhi got frightened. And he promised the goat, I will never ever touch meat in my life. The idea is what? People sometimes, even with character, can sometimes slip from their position. If they are not very alert, or not very careful, if they are not very strongly taking shelter of great souls. So, therefore, like a crab inside the ocean is safe, but on the seashore, it can be stamped upon by somebody's boots. You've seen the crab has a shell. Imagine somebody walks with the boots on him. It'll crack. It'll die on the spot. But inside the ocean, it is safe. So Krishna is like the ocean. Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu. So one is sheltered in Krishna's lotus feet. One is very safe and protected. And one should not foolishly slip out from good association. So, Tabe Sei Krishna Dase Gaude Pathaila. Vaishnava sabha ke dite maha prasada dila. Vaishnava sabha ke dite So two things he does, Krishna does, wherever he went. He went to Sachimata, offered her obeisances, gave the news about Mahaprabhu returning to Puri, and he would give her Jagannath Mahaprasad. And he would earn her blessings and Ashirvad. Then he would go to the home of Advaita Acharya Prabhu. There also he would do the same thing. He would offer obeisances, give them good news. All the Vaishnavas would be jubilantly dancing. And he would give them Jagannath Mahaprasad. Imagine you are giving a good news also and giving Mahaprasad also. How happy devotees will be, you can see. Actually, if one is very intelligent, one can actually attract blessings by pleasing the devotees. Because Krishna is also trying to please the devotees, correct, no? So if one makes a special effort to give some good news, therefore there are some intelligent devotees who bring some Swami Prabhupada or something from Vrindavan, like from Giriraj. So they go devotee to devotee and give one piece from which I have brought for you. So every time a person receives that Swami Prabhupada, he puts in the mouth, it is nectar, then immediately he will think this devotee is such a wonderful fellow. You know, he remembered me and brought me this thing. So when they get good wishes for the devotee. By those good wishes, you know, you are able to please the devotee, and that actually pleasing the devotee attracts Krishna's grace also upon the devotee. So that was their intention in sending Krishna Das to all important Vaishnavas and give the news to them, and also give Mahaprasad to them. And everybody will say, sadhu, 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 wonderful. You know, Krishna Mate Rastu, may Krishna bless you, may Krishna protect you, may Krishna guide you, may Krishna shelter you. Like that, he will get blessing of everybody. So he distributed Jagannath Prasad also. Tabe Gauda Deshe Aila Kala Krishna Dasa Navadvipe Gela Taha Teha Sachi Ai Pasha. Yeah, he went to the home of Navadvipa, Mother Sachi's place, went to Bengal. Mahaprasad Diya Tare Kaila Namaskara. Dakshina Haite Ayala Prabhu Kahe Samachara. So he did Namaskar and then he told her the news about Mahaprabhu returning back. Shunya Anandita Haila Sachi Matara Mana. Srivasadi Arayata Yata Bhakta Gana. Yeah. So Sachimata became jubilant hearing this. She became very jolly. And then eventually he also went to the other devotees of Navadvipa, like Srivas Thakur, Srinidhi, Sripati, Sriram, all the brothers of Srivas also. Shunyasa Bara Haila Paramavullasa. Advaita Acharya Grihe Gela Krishna Dasa. Everybody was in Parama Ullas, supreme happiness. People, devotees, all Vaishnavas started singing and dancing. The Mahaprabhu is back, Mahaprabhu is back. And Advaita Acharya Prabhu's home he went after that. Acharyere Prasada Diyakari Namaskara. Samyak Kahila Mahaprabhu Rasamachara. That means completely he told everything about Mahaprabhu to Advaita Acharya, because he's the leader, no? Not only he told him Mahaprabhu has come back, he must have told many other news also. Because after Mahaprabhu went to Jagannath Puri, he delivered Swarupa Bhattacharya. Is it not true? And then Mahaprabhu went to Alalnath, then he went to South India. Because he was a personal servant, no? Who? Kala Krishna Das. So he witnessed Mahaprabhu's activities in South. Therefore, Samyak word is used. Samyak means he told everything. Which all holy places Mahaprabhu went. And which deities he saw, and which people he met. He met Ramananda Rai, he also met Venkata Bhatta, correct, no? He met the Buddhists also. There were some favorable people, there were some unfavorable people, different places. In this way, he told Samyak all the news about it. And why he told the leader, Advaita Acharya Prabhu? Because then he will spread the word to others, everybody else. So, Shuni Acharya Gosaira Ananda Haila Prema Veshe Hunkara Bahu Nritya Gita Kaila. So Advaita Acharya Prabhu, as soon as he heard it, he became not only pleased, he went into great ecstasy of love. He made rumbling sound and he danced and chanted for a long time.
हरिदास ठाकुर हरिहर परमानंद वासुदेव दत्त गुप्त वासुदेव दत्त गुप्त मुरारी सेन शिवानंद. So in this way the news reached everybody else also. Vasudev Datta, Murari Gupta, Shivanand Sen, everybody. Acharya Ratna Ara Pandita Vakreshwara. Acharya Nidhi Ara Pandita Gadadhara. See, there is Acharya Ratna. Acharya Nidhi is, I think, Chandrasekhar Acharya, I think. We can check it. Vakreshwar Pandit. They were all pleased to hear the news. And then the names are given, if you see. Yes, Sriram Pandit, Damodar Pandit, Sriman Pandit, Vijaya and Sridhara, they were all very pleased to hear. Then Raghava Pandit, Nandanacharya and all the devotees became satisfied. How many can I describe, he's asking? So there are so many devotees living there. Shunyasavara Haila Parama Ullasa Save Meli Gela Shri Advaitera Pasha. All the Vaishnavas gathered together and went to the leader of all the Vaishnavas' home. Who is that? Advaita Acharya Prabhu. So they all went to Advaita Acharya's home to know the next plan. What should we do now? Acharya Rasabe Kaila Charana Vandana. Acharya Gosai Sabare Kaila Alingana. See, there are certain Vaishnava etiquettes you find everybody following. If you read this chapter, you will see. If somebody has to leave that place and go to another place, they have to take permission from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If somebody has to leave Jagannath Puri and go to give news to Bengal or something, then naturally they have to come and tell Mahaprabhu that I am going out. Similarly, somebody is in Navadvip, if they have to go to Puri, they won't just independently go. Like here you see all the Vaishnavas, now they have developed a desire to see Mahaprabhu. So what are they doing? Yeah, they are going to Advaita Acharya Prabhu's house and asking his plan. And then they will come together and make a plan and then they would go. Actually, you will find in the Vedic times, this coming into the home and going out of the home is a very important thing that it should be told to somebody. Correct? You remember? In India, when somebody is going, by mistake if you say, I am going, they will never allow you to go. I remember my mother would say, if I am telling her that I am going to school, I am going now, she would immediately call me and tell me to sit and say, you cannot go to school today. Because you have told what is some apashakun, some bad word you have said. What is that? I'm going. So you have to say, in Marathi they say, ami yeto. They say, no? Yeto means what? I am coming. Coming, you are going out. But why do you say, I am coming? Because one should always say that I am going and coming. What is the going, coming? What they say? Javaneta, or like that. They say, I'm going and coming back, like that. So, in India, this is a culture. We are going out somewhere. It's not that a son or daughter would just disappear from the house, go anywhere they want. They will tell, where am I going? What is the place I am going? What is the business for which I am going? Whom am I going to meet? And how much time will it take? When will I be back? These are very important. So, in the same manner you find, and then after reaching that place, when you meet a Vaishnava, then there is a first thing, as soon as you see a Vaishnava, there is ecstasy, meeting them after a long time. Then there is bowing down, then there is embracing, then there is giving prasadam, then there is giving of the news, then hearing the news. So you find this, in this similar type of culture you find it with all of them. All the devotees offered respectful obeisances to the at the lotus feet of Advaita Acharya. One important thing we find here in Chaitanya Leela, you know, nobody thinks what is the need of these formalities. Sometimes a modern man, educated man thinks that, you know, Prabhu, what is the need of all these little formalities? Advaita Acharya, they are meeting every day. You know, they are having Bhagavatam study circle in his place, all Vaishnavas assembled together. And Advaita Acharya leads it. So they don't say that, you know, every day we are seeing him, he is seeing us. What is the need of this formality? No. This is not a formality. This is actually an expression of respect, expression of affection. And that is to be done if one really want to cleanse the heart. And then in return, Advaita Acharya embraces them all. Dinaduyetina Acharya Mahotsava Kaila. नीलाचल याते आचार्य युक्ति दृढ़ कैला।
इसे दुई तीन दिन विच मीन्स टू आर थ्री डेज अद्वैत आचार्य पुट अप अ बिग फेस्टिवल इन हिज होम बिकॉज ऑल द डिवोटीज हैव कम सो ही मस्ट अरेंज द बिग फीस्ट फॉर ऑल द डिवोटीज एंड थ्री अवर कीर्तन इन द इवनिंग यू रिमेंबर दैट इन शांतिपुर दे डिड दैट करेक्ट लाइक दैट अद्वैत आचार्य सेलिब्रेटेड द फेस्टिवल सो वॉट इज द फेस्टिवल सेंटर्ड अराउंड नो द फेस्टिवल सेंटर्ड अराउंड महाप्रभु हैज कम बैक दैट्स अ फेस्टिवल because nobody knew how long will he go for preaching where all he is going when he is coming back no there was no clarity on that now mahaprabhu has come back so there is a festival remembering chaitanya mahaprabhu remembering krishna and dancing singing taking prasadam meeting all vaishnavas with each other and then they all together decided with advaita acharya what is that drida kaila means you know neelachala yaite he is saying that so they all he decided that we definitely will have to go to Neelachal to meet Lord Chaitanya. He made a very firm decision and announced it to everybody. Everybody knew that.
Sabe meli nava dvipe ekatra hayya. Neeladri chalila sachi matara agnya laya. See again. Now they want to go to Neelachal. So what are they doing? They are going and taking permission from Sachi Mata. Otherwise, whole Navadvip will be empty. Only she will be there. Correct? She will wonder, where are the Vaishnavas? I don't see anybody here. So, when somebody is going out, this is actually a culture. One should, generally, you should tell people whom you are close to. Like, for example, you are going out of the temple also. You tell your roommate should know, your neighbor should know, and your mentor or somebody should know. Correct? No? If somebody is going out for a few days or whatever. So, here you find... They are all going to Sachimata's house now, taking permission, blessing from her, to go to Jagannath Puri. Prabhu Rasama Chara Shuni Kulina Grama Vasi Satya Raja Ramananda Milila Savehasi. Yeah, so Satyaraj Khan, Ramananda, all of them came from Kulina Gram, and they also wanted to join Aditya Acharya and going to Neelachal. And then all names are mentioned here, if you see. You know, from Shrikhanda, who all would come? Mukunda, Narahari Sarkar, Raghunandan. They're all from Shrikhanda. Yeah. And then they also came to accompany Advaita Acharya. And then, Sekale Dakshina Haite Paramananda Puri.
Sekale Dakshina Haite Paramananda Puri.
Ganga Tire Tire Aila Anadiya Nagari. So, Paramananda Puri came from also South India. We all know that he left now, Pandharpur. Actually, he even left Pandharpur before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu stayed some more days there. So, traveling along the bank of Ganges, he ultimately reached Nadia. And then as soon as he came to know this. Aira Mandire Sukhe Karila Vishrama Aitare Bhikshadila Kariya Sammana. So, at Navadvip, Paramananda Puri took his boarding and lodging at the house of Sachimata. She provided him everything very respectfully. And now, that time he comes to know that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come back. Prabhura agamana teha taha nishunila shigra nila chalayate tara ichahaila. Yeah.
While residing at the house of Sachimata, Paramananda Puri heard the news of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's return to Jagannath Puri. He therefore decided to go there as soon as possible.
In fact, he will not wait for anybody. He came to know that they all went to Advaita Acharya's home and they are putting up a festival. So he thought that may take time. So he left for Puri. Paramananda Puri will go before. You will see that. Prabhura Eka Bhakta Dvija Kamala Kanta Nama Tare Laya Neelachale Karila Prayana. Yeah, there was a devotee named Dvija Kamala Kant, whom Paramananda Puri took with him to Jagannath Puri.
सत्वरे आसियाते हा मिला प्रभु प्रभु रे प्रभुर आनंद हैला पाया तहा रे। When Panandapuri arrived at Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's place, and Mahaprabhu was very happy to see him. Prema prema veshe kaila tare charana vandana teha prema veshe kaila prabhu re alingana. So Mahaprabhu offered him obeisances because he is in Guru's position, no? He is Ishwarapuri's god brother. So he offered him obeisances and Paramananda embraced Mahaprabhu in great ecstasy. Prabhu kahe toma sange rahite vancha haya मोरे कृपा करी कर नीलाद्री आश्रय। महाप्रभु एक्चुअली इज रिक्वेस्टिंग परमानंदपुरी टू स्टे इन जगन्नाथपुरी फॉर एवर। यू मेक दिस यूर स्टेशन। सी महाप्रभु इज इनवाइटिंग एवरीबडी टुवर्ड्स जगन्नाथपुरी। इज कॉलिंग रामानंद राय कम हियर एंड ही इज टेलिंग परमानंदपुरी स्टे हियर बिकॉज 18 ईयर्स महाप्रभु इज गोइंग टू स्टे इन पुरी एंड एक्सपीरियंस द जॉय ऑफ यू नो हाउ Radharani's love for Krishna. So he was in great ecstatic love exchanging. At that time, Ramananda Raya and Swarup Damodar were actually reciting shlokas from. Ramananda would sing songs and Swarup Damodar also would sing song and sometimes recite from Srimad Bhagavatam, very beautiful verses. According to the mood of Mahaprabhu, they would recite a particular verse like that. So Mahaprabhu actually called all his devotees to relish Krishna Prem along with them. So one lesson you can learn from Mahaprabhu's stay in Puri, a devotee first of all should practice and relish Krishna consciousness. Because preaching is actually an outcome of the ecstasy that a devotee experiences. So you find in Mahaprabhu, you know, he only went 6 years out of Jagannath Puri to South India. But how many years he stayed in Jagannath Puri? 18 years. So at the age of 24 he took sannyas. 6 years he went for preaching, another 18 years he stationed himself in Jagannath Puri, the holy place, and by his ecstatic experiences and teachings, he was spreading like a magnet. A magnet's influence, you know, the stronger the magnet, the stronger the influence, no? So Mahaprabhu, simply by experiencing such ecstasy, even now his preaching is expanding everywhere. You can see Mahaprabhu, so he's inviting everybody to Puri. पुरी कहे तोमा संगे रही ते वांछा करी गवड़ा है ते चले आयला नीला चल पुरी। या आई विश स्टे विद यू दैटफॉर आई कम हियर फ्रॉम बंगाल गौड़ देश टू जगन्नाथपुरी। दक्षिण है ते सुनी तुम्हार आगमन शची आनंदित आर यत भक्त गण। Now he has given him the news that Sachimata, everybody is very happy that you have returned from South India. Sabe asite chen, tomare dekite, tansabara vilamba deki aila tvarite. Yeah, they are all coming to see you, but seeing that they are delayed, so I came alone very quickly, he is saying. काशी मिश्रेर आवासे निवृत एक घर प्रभु तारे दिल आर सेवा रकिंकर। एक्चुअली इन दैट गंभीर अवेर ही वाज स्टेइंग हु चैतन्य महाप्रभु वाज स्टेइंग इन द सेम हाउस देर वाज अनदर रूम एंड महाप्रभु गेव इट परमानंदपुरी एंड ही आल्सो गेव हिम वन पर्सन सर्वेंट टू टेक केयर ऑफ हिम। सो आर दिने आयला स्वरूप दामोदर प्रभुर अत्यंत मर्मी रसे रसागर। सो अप टू 101 इज परमानंदपुरी, दैट इज 91 टू 101, 10 वर्सेस परमानंदपुरी रिटर्निंग फ्रॉम साउथ इंडिया टू नवद्वीप एंड देन फ्रॉम नवद्वीप यू नो प्लानिंग टू अलांग विद कमलाकांत. You know, he is leaving for Jagannath Puri, is coming. So all this is 10 verses. One is Paramanand Puri. Prior to that, I told you, Kala Krishna Das going to Jagannath Puri and, I mean, going to
Navadvip and giving news to all the devotees, especially big devotees like Sachimata, Adyutacharya Prabhu and Srivas Thakur, all of them. So, after Kalakrishna has given the news, the response of the devotees, which we read. Huh? So, what was the response of the devotees? They became very ecstatic, they were singing, they were dancing. They all went to the home of Advaitacharya Prabhu, they offered obeisances to him. He embraced them, they celebrated a festival of Mahaprabhu returning back. And then feast and Harinam Sankirtan and everything. And then they all came to the home of Sachimata taking permission, correct, no? All these things we read till now. Now they are all preparing to go to Puri now to meet Mahaprabhu. In the meantime, Paramananda Puri has already reached. Now the next section is very important section is coming now, which is about Swarup Damodar. This is actually 102 to 129. This is very amazing qualities of Swarup Damodar we are going to read now. This place. Actually, each verse you will see gradually will develop the personality and character and qualities of Swarup Damodar. You know, he was one of the most intimate associates of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In the spiritual world, who is he? Dalita Sakhi. Swarup Damodar is Dalita Sakhi in the spiritual world. And Ramananda Raya is Vishakha Sakhi. Therefore, Lalita and Vishakha are on either side of Radharani. Similarly, on either side of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there is Swarup and Ramananda Raya. See what he is saying here. Aradine, the next day, Ayla Swarup Damodar. Swarup Damodar came here. Now you may wonder, who is this Swarup Damodar? Till now we have not heard about him. So Swarup Damodar is actually, there was one Purushottam Das Thakur. He actually, that Purushottam, he had studied in Varanasi, grammar and everything. And like Mahaprabhu, got Chaitanya name, correct, no? Brahmachari name. He got a Brahmachari name, Swarupa. And he didn't change it. Mahaprabhu didn't change his name. He kept it Chaitanya. He also kept it Swarup only. And then he is a very, very great lover of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu knew him before. And he had taken sannyas. He also had taken, actually, he had taken a Babaji Vesh, which means he would wear simple dress like a dhoti, that kind of thing only. He rejected the sannyas vesh of, you know, danda, you know, and all those things, because he had nothing to give and take anything with the society. All he wanted to do was only service to Mahaprabhu. And Damodar itself means he was always experiencing boundless happiness, boundless bliss in. And you will see his very specific qualifications are going to come now in the following verses. First, what he says, Prabhura Atyanta Marmi, he's saying, very intimate friend of Lord Chaitanya. And Rasera Sagara, he's saying, he's an ocean of transcendental mellows. He's saying, he's Rasera Sagar. Therefore, Mahaprabhu deeply loved him. Here, is he? Read the purport.
Swarup is one of the names of a brahmachari in Shankaracharya's disciplic succession. In the Vedic discipline, there are 10 names for sannyasis, and it is customary for a brahmachari assisting a sannyasi of the designation Tirtha or Ashrama to receive the title Swarup. Damodar Swarup was formerly a resident of Navadvip, and his name was Purushottam Acharya.
I told you, no? Yeah. His name is Purushottam Acharya. Yeah.
When he went to Varanasi, he took sannyas from a sannyasi designated Tirtha. Although he received the title Swarupa in his brahmachari stage, he did not change his name when he took sannyas. Actually, as a sannyasi, he should have been called Tirtha, but he chose to retain his original brahmachari title of Swarup.
Which means they never cared for all this. Just for the sake of the society, to get an opportunity to preach, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu followed certain norms of the society at that time. He took initiation from that Mayavadi Sampradaya. He also, you know, stayed in the home of Brahmanas, and also ate only in Brahmanas' home. Even when he went to Varanasi, Mahaprabhu was very careful. Where was he staying in Varanasi? Chandrasekhar, Vaidya. And he was eating at the place of Tapan Mishra. So he was very strictly adhering to the norms, otherwise he would be criticized. If a sannyasi is socially criticized, then his preaching will not be taken seriously. Mahaprabhu followed that externality. Otherwise, personally, they were completely transcendental. Huh? They never cared for the material situations in the world. Hmm. Yeah. So he was called a Swarup only. Purushottam Acharya Tara Nama Purvashrame Navadvipechila Teha Prabhura Charane. Yeah. So Sarvam, his earlier name, Brahmachari name was Purushottam Acharya, earlier name. Now he has come, he was residing at which place? Navadvip. Huh? Like Nimaya Pandit was living in Navadvip, so he was also living in Navadvip, Purushottam Acharya. Prabhu Ura Sanyasa Dekivan Mattahaya Sanyasa Grahana Kaila Varanasi Giya. So when he saw Nimaya Pandit taking sannyas, shaving up his head, he became very broken hearted. He practically went mad. Hmm? And then he went to Varanasi. And he also went to Varanasi and took sannyas.
Chaitanyananda Guru Tara Ajna Dilena Tare Vedanta Padiya Padao Samastha Lokere.
So Mahaprabhu took initiation from Keshav Bharati and he took initiation from Chaitanyananda Bharati. And then he says that he ordered him, read the Vedanta Sutra and teach it to all others, like that he said. Parama virakta teha parama pandita kaya mane ashriyache shri krishna charita. See, one word, what words are used here? See, parama virakta, he was very renounced. And parama pandita, very learned scholar. And kaya mane ashriyache shri krishna charita. He was body, mind, words were completely sheltered in Krishna's lotus feet, always. Huh? Yeah.
Nishchinte, nishkinche, nishchinte Krishna Bhajiba, yaita karane. Unmade karilateha sanyasa grahane.
Ready?
He was very enthusiastic to worship Shri Krishna without disturbance. And therefore, almost in madness, he accepted the sannyas order.
Sannyasa karila shikha sutra tyaga rupa yoga patta nanila nama haila swarupa.
Yeah.
Upon accepting sannyas, Purushottam Acharya followed the regulative principles by giving up his tuft of hair and sacred thread. But he did not accept a saffron-colored dress. Also, he did not accept a sannyasi title, but remained as a nastika brahmachari.
Yeah, purport.
There are regulative principles governing the renounced order. One has to perform 8 kinds of shraddha. One must offer oblations to one's forefathers and perform the sacrifice of viraja homa. Then one must cut off the tuft of hair called a shikha and also give up the sacred thread. These are preliminary processes in the acceptance of sannyas, and Swarup Damodar accepted all these. However, Purushottam Acharya did not accept the saffron color, a sannyasi name or a danda, and for this reason he retained his brahmachari name. Actually, Purushottam Acharya did not accept the sannyas order formally, but he renounced worldly life. He did not want to be disturbed by the formality of the sannyas order. He simply wanted to worship Lord Shri Krishna without disturbance. Therefore, with heart and soul, he took up the renounced order, but not the formalities accompanying it. Renunciation means not doing anything but serving the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Shri Krishna. When one acts on this platform, trying to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead, one is both a sannyasi and a yogi. This is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita 6.1.
Yeah, 6.1 verse, yeah. So, now Purushottam Acharya, actually he is more than a sannyasi, he is like a Paramahamsa. But, he neither called himself a Paramahamsa, nor did he accept sannyas vesh. Because the moment you accept sannyas vesh, many, many householders, families may want to come and respect you. They may want to invite you to their home for food, prasadam. They may want to serve you, and the crowd may follow you. So he wanted to be aloof from the people of the world so that he can peacefully focus on Krishna. That was his intention. So he's highly qualified. He's like a Rasera Sagara. He's a ocean of bliss. And he's a Panditavara, most learned personality. And he's also Virakta. Tremendous Vairagya he has. So all these are his qualifications, you see. Qualities of Swarup. Despite being very highly qualified, he doesn't want to show anybody because that can become a stumbling block. Yeah. I read this. After taking
permission from his sannyas guru, Swarup Damodar went to Nilachala and accepted the shelter of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then all day and night, in ecstatic love of Krishna, he enjoyed transcendental mellows in the loving service of the Lord.
Yeah. This was his absorption, you see. Now the next two verses are very important verses. Panditya Ravadhi Vakya Nahi Karosane Nirjane Rahaye Loka Sabanahi Jane. See, his Panditya Avadhi means he was the limit of learning. He was so deeply learned. He had like Agada Bodham, we say, no? Agada Bodham means oceanic wisdom. Some people have a head like that, isn't it? Anything under the sun, anything you ask, they will have something very valuable to speak about. He was deeply learned in various fields. And Vakya Nahi Karosane, he's saying. But he wouldn't talk to anybody. Completely like as if doing Maunavratam. He won't talk, he won't do any prajalpa with anybody. Although he was the most learned. And Nirjane Rahaye, always he kept away from the crowds of people. And Lokasava Nahi Jane. Common people didn't know who he was, how powerful personality he was, how learned he was, he's saying. No one could understand where he was. People didn't know where is he staying, what is he doing. Because he was moving like this, at last he came to Puri here to meet Mahaprabhu. He always kept himself in a solitary place. Yeah. Krishna rasa tattva veta deha prema rupa. Sakshat Mahaprabhura dvitiya svarupa. I read that translation, yeah.
Sri Swarup Damodar was the personification of ecstatic love, fully cognizant of the transcendental mellows in relationship with Krishna. He directly represented Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as his second expansion.
Just like Lalita, Vishakhara expansion of, Radharani. Radharani has 8 expansions called Kaya Vyuha, we call it. In the Mayapur, you see, you know, those are all expansions of Radharani only, directly. Why? Because Radharani wants to serve Krishna in various ways. Playing mridangam, playing kartal, making flowers and different offerings. So she expands herself. So he is also not an ordinary person. Swarup Damodar, he says, is a second expansion of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. And he was a personification of ecstatic love. Krishna Rasa Tattva Veta. Veta means he is a knower of Krishna Tattva Rasa very nicely. And he is saying, Deha Prema Rupa. He had a body of bliss. Love of Krishna. Sakshat Mahaprabhura Dvitiya Swarupa. He's saying. So we will stop here for today, because from 112 it will go about Swarup Damodar. This section will go up to 125, it will go. The next class we will continue, because very important verses are coming about Swarup Damodar. Actually, we have to know this section is a very substantial section, elaborating knowledge about Swarup Damodar. Because we need to know about each of the associates of Mahaprabhu very nicely. Because then we will appreciate the exchanges of Mahaprabhu with them also when we read. Yeah. Chil Prabhupada ki, Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki.